Hello everyone and welcome back to the Fun in Dinga podcast. This is the first podcast of 2020 and also one of the first podcasts where I'm sitting down and talking to you by myself apart from having guests recently on the channel, which was a really fun experience. But now I'm going to sit down and begin the year just you and me. You and me, maybe in your earphones or maybe on your screen while you're watching this podcast. And if you don't have much patience to watch throughout like the whole podcast, if you're sitting on the YouTube, of course, you can just go down in the comments, in the description and check out the links where you can listen to this podcast. So you can listen to the podcast while going around, doing your work, commuting, wherever you're going, you can just listen to this podcast at the same time instead of just sitting down in front of the screen. So this today's podcast going to be about kind of defining the podcasting scene on the channel. Also going to share why we started the podcast. At the same time, we're going to talk about creativity and also the wonderful collaboration we did right now. Today, actually, I posted the video in the morning, which was 2019 taught me. And I'm going to share that experience of the whole collaboration with you as well. So let's roll the intro and let's go into this amazing topic of beginning 2019. I'm so sorry. This is the first time I'm making this mistake, which is a very obvious mistake. Beginning the 2020 and talking about all the things which we're going to have in the podcasting this year. Let's roll the intro. I also know that I should change the intro a bit, make it a bit upbeat or something. But we'll work on that very soon. I'm not sure when, but soon. Let's roll the intro and let's get into it. Hi, I'm Suyog, also known as the Fun Indian Guy. I'm a designer, musician, filmmaker, and a mechanical engineer. I'm from India and currently I'm chilling around, traveling around, working around, roaming around, having fun around Europe, and this is my podcast. The Fun Indian Guy Podcast. So the thought of beginning the podcast touched me in May 2018. When I was in Germany, I was listening to podcasts by minimalists and minimalism. And then I bumped into the podcast called Ground Up Show by Matt D'Avella. And I was really hooked to this couple of podcasts. And I was like, I should also start podcasting. First thing, because I really like to talk. Second thing, I would like to bring guests on the channel. And I also happen to know a lot of amazing people who have amazing thoughts to share with us. And from that origin, like the thought origin, we started to make podcast. But it took around two, three months for me to sit down and really start the podcast, which was, I guess, around June, July 2018, when again I was in Berlin when the first podcast came out. Since then, I was experimenting a lot with the medium of podcasting, understanding how to treat it, how to do it, what kind of conversations we should have. Because in the beginning, it was a solo podcast and we did not have much guests on the channel, and I was really experimenting a lot, and that's why I couldn't define what this podcast is all about. I just kept saying that I'm a designer, filmmaker, musician, mechanical engineer and everything, and this podcast is going to be about my journey in Europe, and that's also our kind of the title track of this this podcast. But I was not quite sure back then, that's why I kept it super open. But as now we are proceeding in 2020, we already have around 28 episodes out. This is going to be 29th, if I'm not wrong. And I think I've kind of started to understand what this podcast means to me. So basically, what I think is going to happen in the future on this podcast, of course, we're going to have this beautiful and amazing guest from various backgrounds, not only particularly about design or anything, but we will have these interesting people like Rohan, who comes from completely different background, and we talk about Sanskrit and Vedas. And then we have a couple of designers coming on the channel as well, because I, being a designer, I'm around a lot of designers and I really like the thought process of these people. That's why we keep bringing them. But on this channel, it's the core like tone of voice of the podcast is going to be about the creation and creativity and creating something. And I think creation is a very pure act which everybody or every one of us can do. And these are the things which are super organic and authentic. And I really like to explore the world of creativity and creation, and I'm trying my best to explore a lot of things when it comes to creation. And this still gives me a wide range of topics, because creation is involved in everything. But we can bring people and we can have conversations about creativity, about creations and all those things. So I think talking about creation's creativity and cherishing the purity of creativity and creation itself is kind of going to be the undertone of this podcast, though we will have some specific conversations about specific things. For example, in the next podcast, we're going to have Saili Bharambe, a very good friend of mine, a very dear friend of mine. She's also a designer and a mechanical engineer. And we're going to talk about organ donation in kind of context of India, because she did a project for her master thesis, which was about organ donation. So it's going to be very interesting. Again, it has the undertone of creativity because she took out time and created this service or created this kind of a project where she went into the research of all this organ donation and everything which is around the topic in India. So we're going to listen to that. So I think creation is a very nice, nice lifeline for this podcast in the future. And speaking of creation, the first video of 2019, which I put out there on IGTV, initially the Fun Indian Guy IGTV, and then on the Fun Indian Guy YouTube channel, was the hashtag 2019 taught me video. So I was just waking up the other week, like I think a week ago or maybe 10 days ago, and I was just scrolling through Instagram, which is not a good habit because you just get consumed by scrolling and shuffling through stories and everything. But I was doing that, and while doing that, I was like, I kind of miss this link between you guys and me. Like, I'm creating all these things, I'm getting amazing feedbacks on the things, a lot of people are watching stuff, and I'm getting messages from a lot of people, but I really kind of miss the tangible relationship between you guys and me. And that's why I was like, maybe we can collaborate in some way on this channel, though still the whole relationship is completely digital. But I was like, let's take a step ahead in this direction while I get to collaborate with all these people, be it creators or non-creators, all the people who are around me. So that thought came in my head. Immediately I started thinking about how about we start thinking about lessons learned in 2019, because it was like the last week of 2019. So I just shoot down a story on Instagram saying I'm gonna make a video and I want to collaborate with you guys. So whoever is interested in this idea, just say yes. Then I saw around 80 to 90 people hit yes, against 10 to 15 people who hit no. And then I was like, I have to take immediate step to convert this whole idea into something substantial. So then I started, I created a question where I asked people who are really, really interested in collaborating to write yes in that question's answer and send it to me. Because when you ask people to do yes and no swipe or just selection in Instagram poll, it's very casual poll. But when you ask people to type down that they are really interested in it, it's like a one more filter to understand who is really into it. So then after that, we got around 50 or 40 to 50 responses about really interested in collaborating. And then I started not spamming, but there were still 4 days left for the deadline of this collaboration video where I asked just one question: what 2019 taught you? And I asked these people to send it to me in a video format in just one or two sentences, telling all the lessons they learned, all the important highlights and lessons they learned. And then every day I started to message these people in the morning saying, okay, you have to do this and I'll wait for you guys. And then the next day I was like, yeah, make sure you make the video in a vertical format because it will be good, because the whole video is going to be in the vertical format. On third day I asked them, please message me once you email me the video, because somehow my Gmail was not able to get all the videos in the inbox. They were going not in the spam, but they were somehow going in the promotion. So this was the third message, but this was kind of me reminding them to make this video and to make this collaboration possible, because you have all this enthusiasm about doing something and I'm really not present in their life physically, so I'm very distant from them. And then you say yes and then you get busy with all the things you do in your daily life, and then you kind of lose motivation to do this kind of a collaboration. That's why I wanted to keep like be present in their lives for next 4 days to motivate them to do this video. And on the last day, on the fourth day, I told them, guys, today's the last day to submit the video. But if you're like really shy to put the video down there, if you are not comfortable of making your own self be present on the video, you can also write me your message or send me the audio note. So three of the people actually sent me the message in the text, which I recited by myself on the video. And this was kind of also the fourth reminder to get the people interested and get the people to do these video things. And after that, we received 25 responses, which was mind-blowing and overwhelming. I was not expecting, actually. I thought maybe 4 or 5 people will send me the video, and then I will be like, okay, I'm not sure if I'm supposed to make this video or no, because I made this whole buzz about it, and then now the only few people replied. But luckily we got 25 responses on the collaboration, and then I staged the video together with using the B-roll in between, like using cinematic footages. And about the cinematic footages, the one thing I would really like to share with you guys is, like, I have accumulated the footages of everything I shoot, like the raw footage from my camera, for last 2.5 years. And there are, like, I think around 800 GB of the video footage is in on my hard drive. And while I was making this video, and I was like, I want this specific shot to overlap the conversation or the message this particular person is giving, like the lesson of 2019. I want this particular shot to overlay. For example, there was a shot where this girl was talking about shooting wishes and everything in the sky. And I was like, I know it's a very literal metaphor, but I want a bird flying in the sky to depict the message. And then I plugged my hard drive in, and I went through all the footages, and I used most of the footages which I have accumulated over time. And then I realized why I should back up my footage, because it's very helpful to pick everything whenever you wanted, whenever you want. And I kind of have this amazing library of footages from various places around the world, of various scenarios, of various people, of various festivities, and all these things are readily available for me. So I don't really have to go on this stock video websites and download and buy or purchase the footages. I actually have my own library of footage. It's a very happy moment for me, so the thing is, I started to back up my videos after listening to a lot of YouTubers doing it. And I was like, I don't see the point. I'm just wasting my space. I need more hard drive. This is my second hard drive. And I don't understand why I'm doing this. But now, in last couple of videos, I've started to use the footages from past. And now it all makes sense. So I'm super happy about it. So that video came out today morning, well received by the people. I also posted it on YouTube in a vertical format. So I would recommend you to see this video on your mobile phone and not on the PC, because it will be sad to see the cropped image on the PC. On the video, on the phone, you will have the best experience to watch this video. And after making this video of collaborating with 25 people, it gave me some sort of satisfaction, because then I could, like, it gave me possibility to co-create with so many people who are not around me. Half of them, I think, I don't even know them personally. Some were very famous faces on the YouTube channels. For example, Sarang Sate from Bhadipa, really thankful that he took out time and made the video. Savni Vaze, who's also a stand-up comic. Then there was my blue backpack, Indrajit, who is also a video maker on Bhatupa, Bharatiya Touring Party. All these people put efforts in making these videos. At the same time, a lot of people whom I completely don't know, they just follow me on Instagram. And this is kind of a relationship we have now, that we are now collaborators on the video. So it's also a nice feeling to begin the year with together with all these people. And it gives me a really good satisfaction, and it feels amazing to do this video. At the same time, I really have to thank Ardi Vardi, which is Prachi, because some of the footages in that video, which is the B-roll cinematic footages, are taken by her when we were chilling in Dapoli. So thank you, Prachi, also for helping me with those footages, which are now in my library, because we were trying to create a lot of videos in Dapoli. And then I was like, I really need some footages which I could use in the future, and now they are being used. So purpose is met, let's say. So that's all from today's episode, guys. I just wanted to reflect on whatever is happening and how the podcast will go. I'm kind of glad that I have found the lifeline below this podcast, which is about creativity and creation. So that's all for today's episode, people. I would like to thank you that you stayed till the end, and you have shown so much great support to me throughout my process and throughout my journey on the channel. At the same time, if you can go and tell one friend of yours to listen to this podcast or to see my channel, just out of curiosity or just because you like some of the things I make, it will be really amazing, because that gives us a possibility to increase our family on the channel, to have more people and a bigger hug on the Fun Indian Guy channel. So it will mean a lot to me. Instead of me shouting subscribe, share, la la la, I would just want you to go to one person or one friend of yours and suggest them to see the channel. That way we still have it organic, and the relationships which we are creating are going to be super authentic. That being said, I wish you a very amazing 2020. I hope you have all the amazing things you want this year. I hope you have the most fun out of everything you do, also the fun in now and in the present moment, and not really worry about the future. And that's all. So don't forget to have fun, because having fun is not an option. It's the lifestyle we should follow. And I will catch you in the next one. In next week's podcast, we will have Siley talking about organ donation in India. Amazing, beautiful, and very meaningful topic. Looking forward to that. And that's all, guys. Ciao, ciao. Let's roll the outro. And I'll see you in the next one. I've got this habit of keep on talking even after the end of the video. So as a part of that, it's a sneak peek. Next week, we will have next episode, the second episode of Why, What, How series, where we will be talking about Age of AI. Ciao, ciao.